When a star's life ends, it's not really the end. Some find ways to survive and live on, my friend. Some become something else entirely, transforming or feeding off others' energy. Spooky, eerie things happen in the depths of space. Clinging to life, some very strange things can take place. Dark mysteries that you won't believe. Don't be afraid. Let's see who we can meet.
Sakurai's object. I'm a strange star that was dead, but is now alive. I'm very old and had already evolved into the white dwarf phase of my life. But at the last minute, I had an enormous energy burst, called a very late thermal pulse that put my death into reverse. My shell reignited one last time, and I swelled up into a red giant, which created a thick cocoon of dust around me because my shell flash was so violent. My dust cloud is so thick that it blocks all visible light from me, and now a bipolar nebula is forming around me, you see.
I'm known as the Demon Star. Algol is the name I take. My name means demon head, like Medusa with her head full of snakes. My constant visible changes in brightness make me the scariest star in your night sky. In the constellation Perseus, I'm Medusa the Gorgon's winking eye. But not to fear, there is an explanation. I'm an eclipsing binary star in a triple star system. The regular eclipses of me and my companion make it look like I'm winking at you. When my companion expanded to the larger star, I started stealing mass from it like any demon would do.
Let's go meet the undead stars, lurking in outer space and hiding in the dark. These cosmic phantoms, they're haunting me, finding different ways to consume energy. Let's go meet the undead stars, zombies, cannibals, and vampires, with white dwarf stars and neutron stars, fast-spinning pulsars and magnetars, dark, menacing black holes you cannot see, so many different kinds to meet. When one star ends, another begins. The mysteries behind them are drawing me in.
The case of the disappearing star, a real mystery for Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson. I was a red giant star called M312014DS1. My brightness increased for a little while and then just faded away until I disappeared. No explosion. I was just gone from all sight, I fear. The solution was uncovered. I'm an example of a failed supernova. Instead of ending in a blaze of glory, I'm a collapsed stellar core. My outer layers were ejected, but I collapsed before I could explode. And all that is left of my demise is a dark and creepy black hole.
A white dwarf star with a strange nebula around me. WDJ005311. I'm blindingly bright and hydrogen and helium free. The product of an explosive merger between two super dense white dwarfs. Stars, leaving one rare abomination and burning up all of the hydrogen and helium of ours. When we collided, we caused a supernova, but it didn't destroy me. Instead, I became a Frankenstar, brought back to life, you see. My two stars ended up fusing together, reigniting my core. Wow! My merger allows me to fuse heavier elements like carbon and oxygen now.
Let's go meet the undead stars, lurking in outer space and hiding in the dark. These cosmic phantoms, they're haunting me, finding different ways to consume energy. Let's go meet the undead stars, zombies, cannibals, and vampires, with white dwarf stars and neutron stars, fast-spinning pulsars and magnetars, dark, menacing black holes you cannot see, so many different kinds to meet. When one star ends, another begins. The mysteries behind them are drawing me in.
They call me a cannibal because I'm eating my own planetary system, but I'm just a hungry zombie star that needs energy to go on. I may have bit off more than I could chew, though. My name is WD086310. I ate a planet, and it was a tasty treat for this starving star, but my actions left me with a nasty metallic debris scar. My metal scar shows that a piece of planet I tried to eat didn't agree with me. Its material only spread across part of my surface instead of being absorbed completely.
SGR0501 plus 4516, a runaway zombie star whose origin is a mystery. A neutron star with an extremely strong magnetic field, or magnetar, that's me. In fact, my magnetic field is about a trillion times stronger than Earth's can be. Don't get too close. I'm like a zombie death ray and could rip you apart. Piece by piece. Let's go meet the undead stars, lurking in outer space and hiding in the dark. These cosmic phantoms, they're haunting me, finding different ways to consume energy. Let's go meet the undead stars, zombies, cannibals, and vampires, with white dwarf stars and neutron stars, fast-spinning pulsars and magnetars, dark, menacing black holes you cannot see, so many different kinds to meet. When one star ends, another begins. The mysteries behind them are drawing me in.
PSR J1023 plus 0038, a transformer vampire pulsar.
My companion and I orbit each other every 4.8 hours. A millisecond pulsar, I produce both a radio beam and high-energy winds. My winds hold back the stream of gas that I'm siphoning from my companion. But when that gas stream surges, it creates an accretion disk around me. This disk causes my radio beam to turn off, or at least be obscured, you see. I begin accelerating some of the gases I'm stealing and eject them into two particle jets then. When all the gases are gone, we start the process all over again.
CBB-292176, a binary star system. Two massive blue stars that will come to an epic end. The smaller of us will feed on the larger one's atmosphere until an open-stripped supernova. Then the resulting neutron star will do the same to the other blue star. The leftover two neutron stars will then spiral towards each other until they collide, creating the spectacular explosion called the Kilonova. Kilonovas are like cosmic factories that churn out the heavy elements they disperse through an epic explosion out into the universe.
Let's go meet the undead stars, lurking in outer space and hiding in the dark. These cosmic phantoms, they're haunting me, finding different ways to consume energy. Let's go meet the undead stars, zombies, cannibals, and vampires, with white dwarf stars and neutron stars, fast-spinning pulsars and magnetars, dark, menacing black holes you cannot see, so many different kinds to meet. When one star ends, another begins. The mysteries behind them are drawing me in.
When a star's life ends, it's not really the end. Some find ways to survive and live on, my friend. Dark mysteries that you won't believe. Don't be afraid. Let's see who we can meet.